Hello guys, so I'm back with because of some popular demand, my brother wanted me to do some more of this stuff. I thought I'd showcase my super crazy OP build. It's a Deadeye. It's also a bow character, but it's Ice Shot and Barrage with a Headhunter. Headhunter is probably one of, if not the most expensive item in the game outside of a mirror, but a mirror is a consumable. So in terms of an actual item you can use, the Headhunter is probably the most expensive one in the game. The reason why is the last line. When you kill a rare monster, you gain its modifiers for 20 seconds. So if you kill a lot of monsters really, really quickly, you gain a lot of modifiers, and they stack. So, and there's no limit. The only limit is it lasts for 20 seconds. But if you're killing like hundreds of monsters in a matter of seconds, you can gain like insane amount of modifiers. I'll show you. It's actually pretty crazy. Also, I have a pretty good bow. It's actually a really nice bow. I crafted it in Harvest League when Harvest was good. That bow was really good. This is the barrage setup. This is for the single target damage. So it's barrage, awaken added cold, awaken LA damage, awaken cold pen, hypothermia, inspiration. And here's ire, is really good. It's a good chest piece, adds a lot of cold damage, which I'm doing cold damage. For the clear, I'm using ice shot, and it links to awaken added cold, awaken LA damage, hypothermia, inspiration, and mirage archer. The gloves, nothing special, to be honest. The only thing that's special about them is the culling strike. Culling strike means that when an enemy gets to, I think it's 10% life, they die instantly. So it's basically 10% extra damage, which is really nice. Also, it helps with bosses a lot, because bosses has a lot of health, and 10% of a boss health is quite a lot. So Culling Strike, really, really good. This ring, nothing special, life resists, and I have a portal in there. This is another ring. The important thing about this is that it triggers Assassin's Mark when you hit a rare or unique enemy. Assassin's Mark is a curse that grants more damage and life and mana, which is really nice. And this amulet is really good, adds a lot of cold damage and blinds enemies on if you shield them, which I do, since I'm using cold damage. This quiver is really, really good. I have it corrupted with point blank. You can see on the top line it says point blank. That's a passive skill tree. So I save one passive skill tree by having that implicit. The normal implicit is not as good. So this is a really good bow, and it does a lot of damage as well. This helmet is really nice. I have it with an implicit with the increased barrage attack speed, which is this single target, if you remember. Also, it does a lot of damage if you stack dex, dexterity, which I do. So it's really nice. And the boots, yeah, nothing special really there, except cannot be frozen, that's really nice. And of course the headhunter. The flasks, crit flask with the remove curses, speed flask, this is a Cinder Swall of Urn with life gain if you kill an enemy, and it adds a lot of crit chance, as you can see the bottom white line, 78% crit chance. That's really nice. This flask is also really nice for bow characters. It fires two additional projectiles, so that's really good. And this is a life flask. I'm using a shock flask. I think I'm gonna switch to a freeze, actually. Yeah, because I normally use shock when I fight Cyrus, one of the end bosses, because some of the ground AoE damage he does is shock. So it's nice to have a shock life flask there. Okay, so that's the gear. The skill tree is nothing special really. It's a Deadeye with ricochet. It chains one more time the projectiles, which is good. Wait, let's see. One, two, three. Wait, I'm missing one. Okay, that's weird. Huh. There we go. I don't know. I'm playing this in Standard League, and sometimes they change the skill tree all the time from league to league. So if you play in Standard, chances are some things might get broken. But yeah, so ricochet skill chains one time. So if I hit an enemy, it will chain to another enemy, which is really nice. And skills fire two additional projectiles, obviously really good. Far shot, you deal more damage if you're far away, which is really nice for a bow character. You can stand far away and fire at an enemy, and it's super nice. And this one is Gale for, oh yeah, with Tailwind. Tailwind is, you gain extra speed and damage with the Tailwind if you use skills, so that's pretty good. Other than that, like the other one I showcased before, the Bleed character, this is a Lionized Fall, again, with the Corrupted Blood. It converts all these nodes into bow nodes. Normally these are claw nodes, but they are converted to bow nodes. This is a Yule with some life and some cold damage. Nothing really special, honestly. And this is also same thing, cold damage, life, some resists. This is a Watcher's Eye. This is pretty expensive because I have two mods on it that I use. Both damage penetrates 15% cold resistance while affected by hatred. Hatred is an aura that adds damage, so it adds cold damage. So the cold pen for that is really good. And the line about it, 15% increase attack speed while affected by precision. So yeah, I use precision as an aura as well, so I always get 15% more attack speed, which is really nice. Down here we have the I only have one cluster set up. It's pretty nice. The large cluster U is it's three. It's Calamitous, Strategy Destruction, and Martial Prowess, and it has two dual sockets. Drive Destruction, it's Life Leech, and I have a chance to maim. Maim deals more damage. And the Life Leech helps with the survivability. Martial Prowess, attack damage, attack speed, damage with ailments. I mean, yeah, just more damage. Calamitous is also just more damage, chance to freeze, elemental damage with attack skills, and yeah, pretty good stuff. Okay, so the medium cluster use. This is Precise Commander and Pressure Points. Now, this is a really good one. So, Precise Commander, you and nearby allies, but doesn't matter. But you have 25% increased crit chance and 10% crit multiplier, which is really, really nice. Super nice for a crit build, which this is obviously a crit build. The other node here, pressure points, you have a chance to deal double damage and more crit chance, which is really, really nice. This duel is cold damage, attack speed, life and some resists, so pretty nice. This duel is Precise Commander and Precise Retaliation. So Precise Commander we went over here, it's the same one. Precise Retaliation though is 60% increased crit chance if you haven't blocked recently, and 30% crit multiplier if you have blocked recently. Now, I don't really block. I use sometimes I manage to block, so but most of the time I don't block, so I get crit chance. But if I do block, I get even more damage with a crit multi. So super, super nice. And that's damage with both attack speed, life speed, and resist. And yeah, these nodes are just damage nodes, dex nodes, damage, health, damage, health, health, and more damage, health, damage, health, and damage. And this is dodge, basically survivability. Okay, and the anointment I use for the amulet is Heart of Ice, right? It's up here. Increased cold damage, and it penetrates cold dress as well. And cold damage leeches energy shield, which doesn't really affect me that much. But the cold damage and the cold pen is really nice. So yeah, that's the build. And let's start a nice music video and let's do some apps and showcase the stuff. I'm also gonna put myself in D&D because I don't wanna be disturbed by people while I'm doing this recording. All right. So here we go. Here we are gonna play Electric Universe and Chico, which is a Brazilian guitarist, and Electric Universe is a German psytrance artist, and they did a psytrance concert in the Rostock Harbor at a boat because of the corona epidemic. They couldn't play at any festivals or concerts or anything, so they did a live stream from a boat, And it's actually really, really cool. So I'm gonna play that one. Hopefully it will not be copyright claimed on Twitch and YouTube. I hope not, but if it does, then so be it. All right, here we go. It's not showing up for some reason. It did a moment ago. What I can do is I can add another display capture, or actually, maybe I need to. Yeah, I need to change this. Yeah, there we go. There we go. I just needed to change the source. All right. All right, let's do a map. This is in Standard League. This is like a league that never ends. The other leagues rotate on a 3 month basis, which makes the game fresh, but this is in Standard League, so Nemesis, I'm gonna keep the Nemesis because it might be nice to have. I'm not gonna do any of this stuff. I'm just gonna showcase the build itself. I might do some harder content. Also, I'll put this up on YouTube as well, in case Twitch mutes the stream. And also, it's nice to have the videos on both places. Also, Twitch doesn't keep the VODs for all that long, whereas YouTube keeps them forever. So. And that's the boss. This is a max tier map, by the way. So, yeah. Tier 16, I believe. Or maybe it could be 15. I think, I mean, it's a pretty good one. Okay, that's one map done. But maps are too easy for this build. I need to do something else. Let's see. Can I do like a. Oh, yeah, I could. I could. Yeah, I could do a fire wave. Yeah, let's do a fire wave. This is gonna be really cool. This is basically an arena with four bosses, or no, five bosses that spawn across the entire arena. Plus, you have a lot of ads all over the place, and Once you kill all the five bosses, you go to the center to reset the encounter, and then everything respawns. And then it's time, so you have to be really fast. And the faster you do it, and the more you kill, the more loot you get at the end. So that's how that works. Alright. Haven't done this in a while. Let's see how it goes. Okay, so we have one boss is gonna spawn here. One boss is gonna spawn there. One here. One over here. And one over here. So yeah, they're spread out across the arena. That's one boss down, two bosses down, three bosses down, four bosses down. Oh Jesus, almost died there. And yeah, that's the five bosses. So now I go to the center to reset the arena. And as you can see in the middle top, at the top in the middle, you see a counter counting down 4 minutes and 30 seconds. So that's how much time I had to kill as much as possible to gain as much loot as possible. There it is. Done with the bosses. We need to reset again. This boss that's annoying because it gets immune for a little bit. There we go. Into immune phase, maybe now. There we go. my god, stop being immune! Let me kill you! There we go. Oh, that was it. Thought I had more time, but okay. Yeah, there's a little bit of loot on the screen, and I'm using a loot filter. If I disable the loot filter, it looks like this. It's even more, but yeah. So now I just gather up all the loot. Just checking to see if they have incubators on all the gear here. Let's do let's do it like this. Let's do this as the map dump. And I'll grab these maps and put them here. These are just maps that I prepare to run. They're like quality and corrupted and all that good stuff. Alright, let's go back and get more loot. Hopefully we can get all the loot in all the six portals. So you definitely wanna pick up the best loot first, and then if you run out of portals, then maybe you miss like an orb chance or something. It doesn't really matter. I mean, but yeah, you want to pick up as much loot as you can, of course. What I'm doing is resetting, because as you can see, the loot is like moving around. Kind of weird, so you can reset it so it's easier to pick up That's why I'm. Yeah, that's why you're seeing that stuff. let's wait with that one. Well, we have 4 portals left, so hopefully this should be here. So yeah, hopefully I will manage to get all the loot, but hey, if I miss some loot, doesn't really matter. To be honest, it's fine. I'm just doing this for fun, to showcase the build and also showcasing the awesome music. So yeah, go follow Electric Universe on YouTube and give him a sub and a like and all that good stuff. And hopefully when the coronavirus dies down, we can go to a festival and see him live. That would be pretty awesome. I think that once the coronavirus dies down and it's like completely gone, everyone is vaccinated. I don't know for sure, but I think that festivals are just gonna boom like crazy. Everyone is gonna go to festivals and listen to music, because we haven't been able to do that for a while now. So yeah, I think it's gonna be completely crazy. I think like all the festivals are gonna sell out like instantly. Honestly, I really do. Because people are so fed up with this corona shit. They want their normal life back. And so do I. I'm really tired of this bullshit. But I'm going to be vaccinated pretty soon, I think. I haven't been able to reach the vaccination place yet, but I guess there's a lot of pressure on them. There's a lot of people that wants to be vaccinated, obviously. Okay, so we picked up everything that's of relevance, and let's see. These are 86. So I'll pick up these 86 ones as well, even though they're magic. I'll scour them and I will auk them to see, because sometimes you can get some really really good stuff from doing that. So yeah, I definitely do that on eye level 86 though, and maybe 85 and stuff like that. But low level stuff, you don't really need to do that. Alright, I'm not gonna price check and craft and do all that stuff with this, because it takes a lot of time, and it's really boring to watch, so I'm not gonna do that. In fact, I think I'll probably end the stream pretty soon. Let's see. Hello. Yeah, I think I'll skip to the last song, and then I'll end the stream, because yeah, this wasn't really planned at all, really. I just felt like, hey, yeah, maybe I should do this. Alright, we got all the loots. Elle loots. Nice. Man, I love this music, it's so good. And especially with the guitar as well, added on to the already awesome psytrance, makes it just so good. Let me... let's see, where is it? Is it... Yeah, I think this is the last song. This is so good. Let's do one more map while we listen to this. Yeah, that was boss. sorry boss. We'll do maps until this concert ends. Because I don't want to stop right now.
All major agents begin with visionary training. transpersonal
That was the boss in this map, sorry man. I bet the boss goes onto like game forums and complain like, come on man, I'm supposed to be a boss, I'm supposed to be strong and difficult, and these guys just one shot me. Bet it does die. Yeah, that's that map. Actually, what we can do instead of doing just maps, because maps are a little bit boring, can do this elder fight. Oh, misclicked the thing. Let's see how quickly I can kill this dude. This is one of the okay. Wait, what? Yeah, this is one of the end game bosses, and I think it's gonna die pretty quickly. Phase 2, now we have to kill these portals that spawn and the adds, and we have a dude, the shaper is closing the portals, so the game is like the shaper versus elder. This is elder and this is the shaper, and they kind of fight. They are in like different factions, I suppose, and this is the elder fight. I can do the shaper fight as well, but oh fuck no, the music is over. Well, this fight is over soon anyway, so. It's kind of fitting to end with the bang. Here we go. And it's dead. Boom. Although I didn't get much good loot, but whatever. It's fine. Okay, well, that was about 46 minutes of streaming, showcasing the Ice Shot Barrage Deadeye character that I have, that is kind of stupidly overpowered, to be honest. I obviously spent a lot of in-game currency to make this character as good as it is. But yeah, this is like a showcase on how super fun Path of Exile can be. So yeah, check it out. Check Path of Exile out, and also check out Electric Universe and Chico, the Psytrance concert in Rostock Harbor, Germany. I'll put the link in the description on the YouTube and all that good stuff. I can also put the build guide for this character in the description as well, so you can take a look at that. All right, I'm out. Take care. Bye bye.